stone. I feel like I'd be better off on my own. Well, I don't wanna lose you in the smoke. I feel like I'd be better off all alone. We can stay up until it's light. Forget my fate that's kicked off to the side.
Yeah. show shot. So high, keep it cracking like it's the dope spot. Fuck the evil corporation, it's Mr. Robot. Type music got him moving, now this is a show shot. To push your constitution, get loose as a wet noodle. Got him dancing on the lancy, as fancy as pet poodles. Got him downtown swinging like dancing little fame. Send my enemies back to the essence from which you came. What inspired you? What is it you're trying to do? Somebody told you you should probably give it up, they lied to you. Never aspire to the average or the mediocre. Let the greatness inside of you take over. Stockbroker or an activist, a soldier or a pacifist. Life a chain reaction, you a link or you a catalyst. Walk in a house of God, your house of cars starts collapsing. Fashion killer higher than villains and ass. Fuck title, you provoking a reaction? Are you slow or are you fast, man? Are you smoking or are you passing? Are you wishing, are you hoping, are you hoping for some action? A serious and hard attacks, man, am I joking, am I laughing? If you see me crack a smile and I got paid tonight, I'm with my hair like some mama made a plate of rice. They say you need to dumb it down like that's some great advice. Nah, I'm way too busy showing them what greatness like. Everywhere I go, I get a standing ovation. Speaking the codes, my game got no imitation. Nope. It's innovation. We're now experiencing greatness. We're now experiencing greatness. We're now experiencing greatness. We're now experiencing greatness. When I was furious, I'm prepared for the greatness. Spit a flow that'll strip your soul bare and naked. I ain't scared to say shit. Yeah, God is the greatest, no joke. I have my foes going through spiritual anguish, cause I'm clearly his favorite. Never here for the fake show, staring at the so-called gangsters. The OGs with nothing to play with. This is much more than entertainment. Still hit on my marlin, walk through the water, so my name is my name.
Hello everybody and welcome to the University Esports Masters. My name is Jack Jules Wright and I'm joined by Severin Last Saber Eistad, and we are ready to get into the first game of this evening.
Yep, and what a game it is. It's between Universidad del Estudio de Milano versus Universidad Complutense Madrid. And to make it for you guys, I like it simple here. It's Italy on the blue side versus Spain on the red. So it's going to be a huge game. I think both teams already, we do apologize for the slow delay. Unfortunately, there were some issues on the side of the Spanish stream. So we wanted to wait for them. Of course, it's the Spanish playing, so we don't want them to miss this game for themselves.
No, definitely not. And I'll tell you what, Italy, they're looking pretty good right now.
Yeah, definitely. After yesterday's win, they showed dominance. They showed really good macro play. Yes, some of them fell behind in lane, but that didn't matter when they got into these team fights, right? They killed the participation across the board was good. Even solo kills somewhere and into these lanes. So they really showed it. Where on the other hand, Pain was on the other side of that coin. They played a decent game in the laning phase, but made some poor decision in late game, which caused them a loss against our hometown Aston University. So they managed to lose a game, leaving them at 1-1 after picking the win on the first day of the tournament. But we should look into the board a little bit, because this is one thing we don't have in the graphic. So, Jeff, open yourself, sir.
Which graphic is that one?
We don't have a graphic. You just have the leaderboard itself.
Oh, no, I do not. You're going to have to quickly run down that for me.
Okay, so currently we're standing at a nice tie here. Two teams only playing one game, which is Italy and France. This will be balanced out a little bit today. But we have Italy with one win at the top of the table with no losses. Then we have Portugal, Aston University, and University of Madrid. So all three teams are on one win, one loss. So they're sharing that point. And this leaves day three as another day where anything is up for grabs. And then you have France right at the bottom with one loss. This might change today. This might even out a little bit more. But the further we go in the tournament, we'll see more and more differentiations coming up from here.
Yeah, and really, it's all to play for at the end of the day. I mean, Spain, like you said, they did have a little bit of a disappointing loss. But you know, they can turn it around today, and I'm super excited to see them play. Obviously, the Spanish stream over on the other one, there's a link down, obviously, below the video. You can go check that out. But we are ready, and I think the players are ready. We're going to get into Champ Select very, very shortly. But one question, who realistically are the players to look out for?
Here, to be honest, this will be a choice. Depends what champions they get is which players we're looking out for, right? Yesterday we saw Shayo on this Hecarim. He went off in town. And on the other hand, we saw Stradic, who didn't really have an effect on Hecarim. They both played the champion, so it might be something they look forward to pick and ban. And then you have Serenity Fox, who is a really good Aurelia player. He showed it in the first game against Portugal. And Grande Sketch, right? 10-3-12 on this Jinx. Me and Dowsy yesterday, we were questioning this pick especially against the LeBlanc that was played that game, but he managed to pull it off. He carried on it, and look what happened. They won the game. They're now probably, in my heart, they become tournament favorites.
Now, Jinx, not something we normally see coming into these kind of games, right? We are used to, at the moment, seeing more kind of Ashe, Ezreal picks, especially in more professional play. But Jinx is one of my favorite champions to see, especially in these kind of tournaments, because they can go off at literally any time, you know? And Italy really did show that, and I just cannot wait to see if they do pull it out again. But bans coming through already, obviously, on the side of... on the Italy side, they do have the Aurelia ban and the Gangplank. But over on the Spanish side, Karma and a Shen ban as well. So quite a few power picks already banned away, and quite meta, you'd say, as well. And the Darius ban, a last ban, targeting Rengoland, who, again, has been showing up on this Darius.
What I want to see here is Rengoland, right? We mentioned this yesterday. Rengoland is a Rengo main, and he has not been banned. Yesterday, he was banned against them. I want to see if he picks them up here, or he spares them and goes, this is my solo queue pick, I'll leave it for now. But it's just go into the bans a little bit more. Aurelia, Gangplank, and Jax. These are three champions Serenity played, right? He played Aurelia in day one, where he managed to win. Yesterday, he played Jax. It wasn't a great effect, but he still played it decently well. Gangplank, a standard ban. This is pretty much meta ban right now, because he has good AD scaling, he has escape ability from CC, and his global ultimate just pressures lanes so hard. Whereas on the other flux, we have the other side of, it's pretty much the flipped coin, right? Karma and Shen, another set of meta bans, top lane ban here from Shen, and a focus on the Darius for Rengoland.
Yeah, and I think my client is bugged, unfortunately. I cannot see the picks whatsoever. Which might be a little bit of a problem, considering I'm the one streaming it as well. So you're going to have to lead us through this one. I'm completely blind. The viewers are completely blind.
Okay, guys. In which case, you're going to have to trust in my voice. I'll take it a little bit slow. So we see a first pick on the blue side of Hecarim. So again, I said this is going to be a pick between Stradic and Shayu. Hecarim is picked in favor of the blue team, so they'll be taking it. Shayu performed really well. He styled fools on it, so you'll be taking it again. Whereas on the other side, we have Serenity Fox picking Braum for Arcane, as well as the bot lane duo Sivir being picked into for Cervic. So it's something they played before. Sivir was played by Cervic yesterday. Again, it wasn't the greatest use of it. Maybe they just didn't have a really good game on it. So we'll see how that goes through there. Unfortunately, this bug is quite annoying. So my voice will be the sole guide through this.
You'll be carrying us through this.
I'll be carrying you through this right now, yes. Following the picks in, by the looks of it, it's something we haven't seen before. Shiny God has picked... okay, so this is a placeholder right now. Which is, obviously you guys can't see this, so it doesn't even affect you. I can lie to you and you'll get away with it. But we see a Blitzcrank, which is a placeholder for Janna, followed by Lucian pick. So that's another bot lane pick. A really good phase for them to pick this, because now they didn't reveal any top laner, any mid laner. So they have this availability for a choice to at least counter one in these lanes. So it is a Janna Lucian bot lane, so they will be playing it a little bit safe here. The extra AD on Lucian is really good from coming up from Janna's shield. And we are yet to experience the picks from the side of the Spanish team here. The Skulls, prove me wrong, instantly picked two picks. So we see a Maokai and Cervic on the side of the Spanish Spanish side. Maokai going for Serenity Fox. So this is the first time we will see him on a tank champion here. The first two games he has played carry junglers, and those seem to be his favorite. Graves following it. I'm expecting this is a strategy pick. I don't think this is a Pain Valdi pick right here. And which is a good pick, right? He does plenty of damage. He has good wave clear, as well as good jungle clear. But I'm not sure if he'll be able to phase this against Shiryu's Hecarim. If he is able to out lane him or out jungle him early, this will be a good advantage. Otherwise, he might fall quite behind on this Hecarim. And to finish it off, let's have a look. Another. Okay, I need to let the other team know I don't have them added. Give me a second.
No worries. Well, we'll talk a little bit about the bottom lane. I mean, Sivir, Braum into Janna, Lucian. Sivir, Braum, realistically, they seem to want to play passive, right? Just wait till kind of the mid game when they can team fight, use On the Hunt from Sivir, get Maokai on top of the carries. Janna, Lucian, maybe a little bit more aggressive from them. Just because, obviously, Janna shield, you can put down so much harass in the lane. And this Lucian's going to have the world of protection, especially as they're nearing the level 6 mark.
Yep, and I think, did the client quit for you?
Yeah, it did. We're back in the lobby, so.
Yeah, so we might be able to fix this for you guys. So I won't run it through again. We'll just wait till the shiny god comes back, and we'll be going straight into the game. They know what the picks are, they know what the lands are, so it should go quite quickly through here.
What are the last two picks for the Italian side?
Well, the Italians, it was... What did they need? They need a mid laner and... Oh. It was Ahri and Olaf. There you go. Ahri and Olaf. So, we'll see Rengoland. We're just waiting for Shiny God to connect to the game, I believe.
So, hopefully they will show up this time. This bug is really annoying, but...
Are they showing up for you?
The bans are. Right. So, that's a good thing.
The moment of truth?
The moment of truth? Nope. I got nothing. The grey portraits, but... So we'll quickly run through top to bottom, right? So, over on the Italian side, they've got the Olaf in the top lane, I assume. Hecarim in the jungle.
Yes,
Ahri
sir.
In the mid. Hmm? Lucian, Janna as the bottom lane duo.
Of course.
Over on the Spanish side, you didn't actually tell us the mid lane.
So, we'll have a Maokai in the top lane, Serenity Fox on Maokai, Shradich on Graves, Pain Valdi on Vladimir, right? So, this is another carry. I'm surprised he didn't go for this Azir pick. He was playing really well, outstandingly well in the first game. He had insane damage and 77% kill participation, so it was topping his team of that. But he chose to go for this Vladimir and to get the sustain, to get this, you know, magic resistance against this team. Following by Sivir and Braum in the bot lane. I'm actually going to spend a second writing it in chat so everyone can see.
Yeah. That's a good idea.
Yep. Unfortunately, you cannot see what's on.
Fantastic.
So bear with me one moment.
I mean, Vladimir is one of those champions as well, right? We've seen him rise and fall and rise and fall out of the meta.
There you go.
And now he's really solidified himself as with the mid-season mage update is one of the top highly contested picks at the moment. Now, obviously, a lot of prime picks were banned away this game. Obviously, Aurelia, Jax, Gangplank, you know, three extremely good champions right now. And Darius as well, super strong, more of a targeted one on Karma, right? So, with this Vladimir, I'm really not sure what this Ahri can do against him, just because of the sheer sustain that he's got in the lane. I think Ahri's going to have a really tough time.
Yeah. It's going to be a pick. I think she's going to... Josti is more going to be looking forward to coming into the top lane, picking off this Tragic Ninja Nungle, and more roaming style play, where he can just push out the wave, roam, get a kill, and just come back. Vladimir won't be able to... Yes, he has quick wave clear, but he might not be able to respond as quickly. And just to look at the summoners, so we have a difference of Josti picking Ignite, to Pain Valdi going for the double mobility summary, which is Flash and Ghost. So it's going to be quite a fair fight in the middle, yeah.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely. I mean, obviously with the Ignite, if she does hit the 6, somehow before the Vladimir, if she's wants to be that aggressive, I mean, you can take Raptors for a bit of extra XP maybe and hopefully hit the 6 before he does. Obviously, because you do get the massive healing from Hemoplague if it lands on one or more targets. So it'll be kind of interesting to see how she plays the lane. And it'll be good to see if she can utilize her ability to roam rather well. What lane do you reckon she'll focus on? Because it really does seem that she's just going to go straight to bot lane. Yeah, I mean, most of the meta right now is focused around snowballing the bottom lane with the mid as well.
I think that's exactly what's going to happen, especially with this Hecarim and Olaf, right? Olaf is running Teleport and Ghost. You have Hecarim who's running Ghost, and we've seen games where Hecarim just appears out of nowhere within seconds, right? He pops that Ghost, he pops that Devastating Charge, Onslaught of Shadows out of nowhere, and we see dead bodies flying left and right. But it's something we're going to see like this. It's just so much mobility on the side of the Italians right here. USM are running Olaf, right? He can Ghost, he has his Ragnarok to completely ignore CC. Shiryu, I mentioned, Devastating Charge, Ghost, Spirit Charge coming out of, Spirit Rush coming out of Ahri, and then you have Lucian Dash as well as the Janna passive movement speed, right? This is going to be a huge kiting team, as well as just, let's just go everywhere and confuse you because we're everywhere, right? If they can pick up Cloud Drakes, it's going to be even better for them.
Yeah, the new buff Cloud Drake's really going to help him out. I mean, Hecarim especially, obviously, with the movement speed, you obviously get additional damage on his passive. The new Cloud Drake, first Cloud Drake, I believe, is 25 extra move speed out of combat, then 50, then 75. So, again, yeah, it'll be really interesting to see what dragons are going to appear. And realistically, I think UCM are going to have to contest these Cloud Drakes just because the movement speed coming out from the blue team, Olaf with the Ghost, obviously, like you said, the Janna with the passive move speed. I mean, they're all going to benefit Hecarim in some sort of way. So I think this is going to be quite a bloody game. And there's going to be a lot of team fights around these major objectives like the dragon, no matter which one it is.
Yep. And even though they have this mobility, I do still give a little bit of team fighting capability to the Spanish, right? They have the Maokai, they have the Savior for the engage, the Vladimir for the damage, as well as the Grace for the burst, right? So they have two protective champions in Maokai and Braum, and they have a good follow-up coming out of Vlad and Savior to bring them in with that utility. Command, you know, her ultimate is really useful in the sort of teamfights, especially to enable this Maokai to go into the backlane, to try and catch this Ahri, to try and catch this Lucian, right? To counter my statement, right, there straight away there's the Janna who can disengage with her Monsoon. So it's going to be explosive team fights, probably a little bit extended here, I'm expecting. But I'm still a little bit favorite into the side of Italy right here.
Yeah, we'll have to see what they do in the early game. And I think it's really going to rely on, like a lot of the games, both in competitive and kind of, you know, just ranked solo queue or whatever. It's going to depend on the jungle and where they're roaming to. Because Hecarim's, you know, he does a lot of damage. And early game, that is. With the Ghost as well being on such a short cooldown, it'll be interesting to see where he paths.
Yeah, and we're into game. We can see your screen. So there you go. Those are the picks.
we weren't lying to you. They were really the picks. But if you've only just joined us, this is the University Esports Masters. Day number 3 is USM heralding from Italy versus UCM heralding from Spain. But going to see where these teams want to go first. And does it look like UCM are wandering down towards this bottom side? Does it look like they're going to go for an invade? I mean, Braum's got a strong level 1.
Yeah, but look at this. This is a read coming out of the Italians here.
Oh, they're going to go straight into the bush. They're going to go head first. That's a massive Janna. Oh my goodness. That whirlwind knocked off all 5. They might be able to chase this down. They're trying to kite it out as much as they can. Both teams are going to have to back off here. But Hecarim popping the Ghost so early there. And Braum even popping Flash.
Yep, I think he popped the Ghost for extra damage here. He wanted to make sure he gets a little bit extra damage and try to get a kill here. Then, unfortunately, they managed to pick up. All 10 people in this game have backed off now. They've gone back to base, gaining the health back, and it's just going to be back to normal, right? We see Maokai getting to the top lane. Both duo lanes will meet in the bot lane. And it seems like a jungle start for both these teams as well, right? They'll be picking their extra buff early on, extra camp early on to get that early level 2, so there will not be advantages, and we have a pause kicking off right away.
Brilliant. Because you know what we want with more like pauses and people not getting into game is another pause as soon as you get into game. But Hecarim seems to have DC'd, so he should be back hopefully momentarily. But yeah. Where would you think? Obviously Hecarim's bonus Ghost now, right? So, realistically, can he make these early ganks to pressure the lanes early, or is Graves going to have the upper advantage? Because again, he does have the flash available.
But he doesn't really need the ghost early on. The ghost is more away to ensure the stampeding charge and comes out of nowhere. But he can still use this. Stampeding charge? Devastating charge. the devastating charge. Sis has enough movement speed items if he comes from behind. So this will be no problem for them. They'll be able to. He'll be easily able to gank these lanes. He doesn't need ghost. And look at the cooldown of ghost. Yeah, it's almost halfway up already. And this is what we're talking about. This is why he has become so much more reliable now. Because he has such a short cooldown on Ghost compared. I think it's, 180 seconds, if I'm correct?
It's something around the mark. 180, 150 or something.
Yeah, it's 180 now, especially with the summoner reduced, I believe, from the mastery. He's 153 seconds wait. So this is just over 2.5 minutes.
Yeah.
He's not going to be done jungling by then. So the first gank, Ghost is most likely going to be up.
We'll see what they can do, but Jolsti is just poking away. A pain in the mid lane. Did take that charm first, obviously, to just try and pick up that kill in the level 1, but it's not too much of a problem for her. Obviously, she'll probably just level Q next and be a little bit more potent on the wave clear.
Yep, and just laying down damage. Yep, there you go. The Q has been picked second, so she has got a small advantage now. She will be forcing him a little bit out of lane, but the moment Vladimir picks up a Spectral Cow, and Olaf, look at this.
Rengo land, yeah, he's just putting the hurt to Serena Fox there. Throwing axes all over the show. He's got the corrupting potion as well, so kind of beneficial for him to trade. As he does it like he's just going to shove this top wave in. So that's...
Yep, and with this level 2, he picked up Reckless Swing, so he'll be doing plenty of damage if Market overextends. Yes, he can dodge an axe on 2 with the Twisted Advance, but it's not going to be enough to stop this. And look what Shari is doing. He's going to go for this level 3. He's... No, never mind.
Nope.
Psych me.
Psych. Just going to recall. He's saying, I haven't got Ghost yet, so he's going to wait. But in this bot side, does look like Getch and Shiny are just going to push them up, push the bottom lane duo of UCN up to the tower here. I mean, they can, realistically. Obviously, they got the Janna shield for added protection. Runner Fox again taking a beating. Too many axes to a tree will make the tree fall over.
A Lumberjack Olaf.
Yeah, that should be a skin. Why isn't that a skin?
I'm not quite sure. But just to talk about this bot lane a little bit, Lucian is definitely a champion that is able to deal with Sivir, right? And just comparing, I saw this discussion yesterday, we had a discussion with the casters. Sivir, yes, she can E the piercing light, but look at the cooldown differences, right? So he was able to lay down the spokes so much, he's forcing the Sivir out lane. And what Sivir is trying to do most of the time, they're trying to push the wave into tower and gain some sort of objective where they can go and ult. This is not going to be happening now, so he gains a small CS advantage, but it's evened out across the map, right? There is 6 CS difference in favor of Vlad, and the rest is standing about fair. So just even gold across the map, nothing to speak about so far, until we see these third skins coming in.
And it doesn't look like it's going to be a Cloud Drake first Drake, so we'll see if either team want to prioritize that one. Obviously, it'll be a little bit more beneficial to USM, sorry. As they do have the Hecarim, so we'll see. They do want to go for an early dragon. Graves is just going to recall, though. Raditz on that Graves. So, actually, he's going to go towards the mid lane here. Pain taking a lot of damage, but Hecarim is in this lane as well. But Shortage Horses are going really low. Pain's going really low as well. Gets ignited by Ahri. Trying to get the lifesteal away, but there goes the pool. He might go down. He does get the flash as well. Ahri's going to flash forward. First blood going over to the Ahri. Jolsi burning 2 summoners, but definitely worth in a Vladimir lane.
Well, definitely worth because they wasted. And just to mention, Hecarim's ghost came back up before that slide started. Is this
there you go. Whoa, hang on a minute. Shiryu's going straight into towers. Raditz says, not today. Going to push him away. I thought he was going to dive then. That's a bit risky. He's just going to back off. And Sketch, again, just punishing this bottom lane duo of UCM.
Yep, and we'll just go back into this fight for a little bit more because what a nice turnaround, Ryan. Hecarim stayed a little bit behind. He charged his devastating charge. Waited for a little bit longer. Graves showed himself and then he went in, right? Forced the flash out of Graves because he went low. Vladimir tried to go too far. He tried to pick up the kill on Ahri. Unfortunately, they didn't go enough. And he was forced to pull out. Hecarim was there already on top of him, just following the port until he came out. Picked up the kill with the flash from Jolsti as well. So early level 3 first blood there. So he's picking up about 400 gold advantage from there. And he'll be able to pick up the protobuck quite quickly if he ends up.
He will indeed. Does get double Doran's there, so he's going to be a little bit more sustained for this laning phase. Obviously, Ahri's not going to have too much of a wave clear advantage. Rengar, though. Rengu, even. going to take it to Serena Fox again, but Serena Fox just says not today, just backs off. He's got a lot of sustain, realistically. Serena Fox in his top side is the Maokai, so he's going to be okay. But as soon as Rengoland does have his Ragnarok, it might be a little bit more troublesome for him.
Well, he already was forced to back. He went quite low. His life was flashing red during that fight in the mid lane as well, because we saw the director camera jump back a little bit to top and then back. And look at this beautiful charm landing in the middle again. Playing insanely on this area right now.
Yeah, he's doing pretty well. Caught off with the farm lead as well, so was a little bit behind earlier. But now 47 to 43, not too bad at all. As he does push up to the tier 1 mid tower, but Traditch says, not today. I don't want anything more to do with this mid lane. RE is 6 now as well, same with the Vladimir. But still, summoners down. Important ones, anyway. Both sides.
Yep, and so we have the Spearish as well as Hino Plague up. For damage, there goes the Braum Shield, and this is pretty much the end of the encounter.
Ooh, Pain going low again. Ooh, thought Jolsi was going to go in there.
Yeah.
Just auto-attacking them. Oh my god, there we go. There's the Heavgrim comes in, but Jolsi actually going to go down. Pain picking up a kill. She stayed in range of two tower hits there, really. Just not knowing her limits there of, well, the tower range at least. And Pain's just going to pick that one for free, really. And Heavgrim already using his Onslaught of Shadows.
Yep, and looking in the top lane quickly because Graves is sitting around, but Heavgrim has got the
Well, in the bottom side, though, Shiny's actually going to go really low, and they're going to have to blow the heal and the flash. Arcane almost going down. Ignite not ticking for that last crucial bit of HP. Arcane's going to have to back off. They're out to blow the flash there. Good engage from Shiny and Sketch in the bottom side.
Yeah, so let's just mark this one by one. Because he had a nice little fight in the bottom lane. No one died, but they blew summoners, right? Servic has lost his heal. And now Arcane has lost his flash. This is a crucial flash in case he needs to save Sivir. So they'll be trying to see if Sharia can come from behind. But that's exactly why they think warded it, right? Is the Tribush is defended in case this Heckrim tries to onslaught a shadow from behind. Or even Devastating Charge to really pull off this nice tower dives. That's what Heckrim's good at, because he's able to come in before he even takes his first tower shot. Dealing a lot of damage, plenty of disruptions, and sort of putting this whole team in disarray. Now that's defended with the pink ward, we'll go into the mid lane. Jolsi overextending a little bit there. He took four tower shots for no reason.
Yeah.
Obviously, I believe he's running Deathfire Grasp, and that's the reason he grew it, because the damage from Deathfire Grasp actually triggered the tower, because there were minions in range for him. That was Heckrim to put on Onslaught of Shadows. He missed it, and Ahri just died. Heckrim couldn't fight that alone, and that was the end of that. So Pain Valdi picking up a kill for himself, even at this for a little bit, so it's only 600 gold advantage at 9 minutes in favor of the Italians here.
Yeah, it's going to prove maybe a little bit problematic for Jolsi. He does get a nice charm again. He's been rocking these charms at the moment. Thunderlords goes off as well, but hang on a minute. The Braum in the mid lane now. They are looking towards this dragon, possibly just warding it up at the moment. Shai Yui. That's around about the name. He does clear up a couple of wards as well. So Jolsi just yet again with that blue buff, just constantly pushing Pain under his tower, really putting a lot of pressure down on this mid lane.
Man, he's running Thunderlords. Okay, not quite sure why in that case.
I think he just stayed under tower just a bit too long, underestimating the range. But charm after charm landing, and Pain's just getting, well, the pain brought to him. Traditch as well, looking around this mid side, just gets a ward down, but nothing too exciting yet coming from him. He doesn't want to go towards this mid lane now.
And then we see Sketch actually opted for mining, getting the coal. He had enough of the gold to pick up his saturated. No, it's not saturated. There.
Serrated.
Serrated. Oh my god, saturated. The perfect word for this, right? Plenty of color on this.
Oh, beautiful culling. On the Hunt is popped, actually. There goes the Ultman from Braum as well. Nice Monsoon from Shiny there, actually, to disengage a little bit. Exhaust goes down onto Sketch. I'm not sure if it's going to be a kill. It might be a flash forward from Sketch. Actually picks up Arcane. Are they going to want to go into tower? A little bit of lag there, but hey, gets the kill anyway. Sketch healing out as well. So close to dying, and just in case, Char was going to come down to bottom lane as well. So beautiful double kill coming out from Sketch there as well. Really helping with the Janna Monsoon.
Yep, and this will mean an objective, right? They pick up two kills. Really well played. Good time of ultimates there as well. Culling was eaten all. Yes, two shots were taken by the shield and the spell shield, but it was just not enough. They managed to get the kill. They pick up two kills onto this Lucian. He managed to create a 30 CS lead as well. He's now 3,500 gold ahead of this of the Sivir, right? He's gonna be doing plenty of damage. He's most likely gonna go to buy his second part of the Ghostblade here. He can't clearly afford it yet, but this is going to be quite troublesome in the bottom lane for now. They have lost the tower. What I'm most likely going to see is a lane swap here, right? The Lucian and Janna should go top, try and push that tower there as well, which Olaf has been pushing in, or even roam a bit mid where Pain Valdi is just taking...
Pain's going on him though, and Jolsey actually just ults away, Spirit Rush used. Interrupt you there real quick. Oh, nice flash, but nope, Josie says not today. Flashes straight in, but Sradich even is just there. Clara damage comes through. Josie overextending just a little bit and goes down. So Pain seemed to flash in there to try and get one more Q off, but just didn't happen. Josie had to flash away, but nice re-engage there from Sradich.
Yep, he was a little bit of a bait there because he flashed in, tried to do it, didn't manage to pull it off, and then Jolsey, he was like, okay guys, he just wasted his flash, I can catch him with my last Spirit Rush, nope, Sradich is here on this Graves. And so that's exactly what happened, and Rengoland was actually on his way, like I said, they did manage to do this lane, so, and he was heading down to try and defend this tower, so he's now in the mid lane, cleared the wave, pushed it in there. Ari's coming back, he's gonna head down there now to pick up the wave that Sivir has pushed in for him. And this wave is gonna stop at the perfect place for him to freeze it. This is, if she's able to pick it up and try to 1v1 the Sivir, this might end up badly in favor, not in favor, but this might end up badly for Spain here.
Right, indeed. And you're right, the UCM guys, they are gonna rotate top lane, so Sketch and Shiny up there. Oh, looks like an ult blown from Vic as well. Rengoland says, oh, I'm going to charge after that one. Does use the Ragnarok, but it's going to be a flash wave from Sivir. Has popped the Ghost as well. That's going to keep lasting. 40% movement speed on that. A nice axe hit. Here comes the TP, though. Serenifox wants a bit of this action. Savage going really low there. Gets the heal. Boomerang Bird as well doing a lot of damage. But Serenifox actually coming to the rescue there. Sapling's going to slow Rengoland down as well. Can Savage get a little bit of this action? Might want to pick up the kill with the Boomerang Bird. Rengoland, he knows he's in trouble. Serenifox is going to pick up that kill. Nice teleport down on the overextension there from UCM's top laner.
Yeah, but that teleport meant he had to leave this lane alone and they lose another objective for it. So Rengoland's sacrificing his life to pick up another tower and Shayu's in trouble here.
Whoa, Shayu is in trouble. Sradich is going to be there trying to contest the red bird on Sword of Shadows. His use gets the fear. Shiny God is here as well. Same with Sketch, so they might just be able to take this one away. It's going to get transferred over to Sketch. That's really going to help him out in these lanes, but in the meantime though, that bottom lane scuffle did happen, and they USM did manage to pick up a tower in that trade as well.
Yep, so at 14 minutes, we're sitting at 3 kills to 3, a 3,000 gold advantage because of the two tower pickups in favor of the Italians, and we see the Sketch, yeah, Lucian with two kills, with the Ghostblade finishes, two longswords in inventory, which will go towards the Black Cleaver, as well as the Call, which has 55 strikes left on it, so this will be completed within the next 5 to 10 minutes. This could prove to be insane if he manages to get defended and no one's able to pick him off in a teamfight, right? He's going to be doing plenty of damage with his early armor penetration. He's going to be able to blow up people like Vladimir. Look at this. He's coming into the mid lane. He wants another objective for himself.
He does indeed. Rengoland, though, might be in a little bit of trouble here. Radich is on the side, but Pain actually going really low as well in the mid lane. Sketch taking the tower here, but that tower's almost down. USM seem to have a dominating performance at the moment. It does look like Rengoland actually popped his Ragnarok as well to get out of that one. Radich is just going to back off though. Same with Serenifox, and does it like a three-man stack for UCM on this mid lane.
Yep, and this might mean a tower is only a Braum and Vladimir to defend. No, Braum and Sivir here. Vladimir's backed off. This tower has most likely gone down. Look at the damage.
Yeah, going to down, go down really quickly. Sketch with that red buff as well is really going to just chunk that tower down in it. Could be Dragon Time, if I'm not mistaken. I mean, it is completely open. They did just ping it as well. USM might want to look to go towards that next. I mean, where do you think they need to go after this? They've got all Tier 1 towers 15 minutes into the game. 4k gold lead almost as well for them.
Yeah, they need to go a little bit deep, get these wards, which now Graves is clearing for the top side. But Shari is going for this. Rengo is there to back him up as well, so there's no dual double lane advantage there. They will pick this up quite easily, and a Cloudrake will prove them really well here. They will be able to rotate more, and they'll be able to just force these towers and these pushes, right? Olaf can split push and sit in the lane for days. Then he pops teleport, comes in the fight. Nothing's going to happen to him, right? Yeah, you can plan, try, and teleport, you know, kill him as soon as he teleports, but he Ragnaroks and he'll kill you. That's what happens with LF. He's got his Black Cleaver now, whereas Malka haven't even finished his item right there. Some wards being placed, and they're just going to try to group up here and pick up another tier 2 objective, right? Maybe pick up this Rift Herald, maybe pick up some of the towers in the back, or just force a fight, and because they are ahead, right? They have the 3,000 gold lead, they have the superior team fight, and if they pull it off well, that's where they need to be.
See if they can execute that. Traditch, looking around, but Shayu and Shiny God are just sitting on top of a Pink Ward Death Bush, maybe? Traditch might be a little bit caught on sort of side as this use, the fear comes out as well, but Serenifox is there to help him out just a little bit. He's going to pop Vengeful Maelstrom. He's just going to walk off. That damage reductions would have helped him out. They did continue the dive, but USM, again, well, really showing dominance.
Yeah, so they're going to have to wait for a little bit here, and they have to wait for the Shiryu to get his Onslaught of Shadows back. After that, they'll probably just try to push another team fight. They try to make a pick. Unfortunately, it's a Graves. So he can escape. He can dash back. And he obviously, if anything, he has an ultimate away again to escape.
Oh, yeah, he's all right. Sketch is fine in the mid lane. Must takes a cue from Braum, but he's going to walk away.
I'm having a look. The next Drake will be an Ocean Drake, so not really priority for any of these teams. Maybe a little bit in favor of the Maokai, but it's not a big Drake. I think it's probably the weakest rank at the moment. Going Mountain, Inferno, I forgot the Cloud, and then Ocean. So that's how it's ranking, and there you go. There goes on the Ping and Earth Herald. It is warded, so they might collapse on this. Maokai and Graves coming from the top side. Hecarim is not there. That's the big problem here. And he does not have Onslaught of Shadows.
He does not, and does have Ghost to get there a bit quicker, but like he arrives, and both teams kind of just staying off this Rift Herald just for the moment. 17 minutes. That'll go back. That'll go down in about 2 minutes' time. So they might just want to leave it, but here comes Hecarim. Again, no Onslaught of Shadows, but Jolty's actually going to flash straight in there. That's going to be a... Oh no, Hemoplague was popped. Did get the healing back from it as well, and just deterred USM away from that engagement. And On the Hunt as well was popped from Cervic.
Yeah, but was it worth... look at this, Italians. They popped one Flash, one Ignite, and a Spirit Rush, right? What did they get in advance? They get Cervic Flash, they get On the Hunt, they get Hemoplague, and they go back to having this lane objective. Lucian's getting bot to pick up more CS. Rengoland with Godrobi are going top, so Godrobi's going to bake. Rengoland's going to pick up more CS, and they're just going to grow these advantages, right? Because they're controlling these waves, and this is where the macro play comes in. They control the waves, they go mid, so side lanes are pushing out. If someone goes there, they take the advantage. They either try to fight the 5v4, or they try to somehow win the split push. And against Maokai, Olaf has an easy time in that lane.
Yep. You aren't half wrong, and I mean, with that Sivir ultimate down, we were talking about Hecarim's ultimate earlier, and Onslaught of Shadows is available now, so maybe they'll look for a pick or some sort of team fight. Obviously, they won't be able to escape with Cervic's ultimate, but again, On the Hunt is on a very short cooldown as well, so they might just want to just wait it out just a little bit, play a little bit more safe, and they're just going to get a few wards down, it looks like, on the red side of UCM's jungle. Ulti there as well. Spirit Rush already available. Really short cooldown on that one. And they short cooldowns for ultimates all around, right?
Yep. And they have the inside track on the tower. Rengoland managed to push the wave already. Unfortunately, they focus on the red buff. They did manage to take it away. And Graves is on his own.
He's on his own. Shayu goes straight on top of him, but has got a tower to protect him, so Raditz will be okay.
Still getting him to half health, so this is what we're going to be looking at. And they're going for this Rift Herald again, and... Spanish are calling it. The Spanish team are like, okay, guys, this is the Rift Herald. But Graves and Sivir are a little bit behind. And they're burning this Rift Herald quite quickly. Let's see if this fight breaks out here.
We're sealing up to stay out really quickly. The Ventral Most Rings popped. Hemoplague on two members. He's going to get a humongous bit of healing there. Zerenifox actually picks up Shiny. And Shiryu's going to go so low, popping the Ghost. He is surely going to go down. Rift Herald commits suicide in that whole affair as well. Says, I don't want any more part of this crazy world. But this might be the turnaround from UCM. They were able to pick off one kill, netting them a little bit of gold. And Shiryu as well, he might just get the execute here, which would be the smart move to make. But beautiful. That'll be the execute. Yep, it's going to be the execute. But beautiful Hemoplague coming out from Pain. And Serenifox following up with the Ventral Maelstrom just really helped them sustain in that long team fight. In that very short team fight, even.
And I think they didn't expect it for them to be so confident in that play. Spanish team decided to go in. They went, we're pressing all these buttons. He flashed in, he put the Hemoplague, and they sort of confused Shiryu, right? Shiryu somehow, I'm not sure, his Onslaught of Shadows went in the wrong direction. I'm not sure if he tried to escape with it or what happened. He didn't land it on anyone. Vladimir then just kept on dealing his damage, and luckily for them, only Shiny God died. If it could have been way worse. And again, Riftero died in the middle of that, so they couldn't even pick that up as an objective. So they're still quite far behind. They're still 3,000 gold behind, but they are showing teamfight dominance here, right? They're showing that they can conquer the enemy team, and they will be the victors if the teamfight breaks out, which is the next teamfight most likely will be happening on this Drake in 20 seconds.
It's going to be the Ocean Drake, and obviously you said it's not the most key and influential Drake, but hey, it's a free regen, and it will really help towards this the later game, if it ever does come to that. But 21 minutes in, there's only a 4k gold disparity on the side of UCM, so they can easily pick this back up. Like you said, they have got a really strong team fight. We'll see if they can put that to good use. Whoa, Arcane going really low. They're actually going to go in on this. Brawl Mold separating the whole team. Venture Burst and Pop from Serenifox, but Ari's in the sidelines trying to do something, and Shiny God picked on yet again, but Sketch is just going to pick off Serenifox, who's just left completely alone in that fight.
Yep, and both Serenifox and Rangolin went deep into the enemy team line. Market was pulled by the Janna as she flashed over the wall, so he had a long trip down, and they now pick up the dragon. But the damage,
they might want to go back in on this. Pain does pop the pull, but he's in a little bit of trouble. He's going straight in the fight. Ari actually charmed him there. Shot you, it's going to be up that kill. Sketch is going to go in, picks up another two as well. This is surely going to be at least a couple of towers. USM turning that one around, and UCM just overstaying just a little bit too long.
Yep, they tried to contest the dragon. Dragon died, and four kills were picked up on the back of, or three kills were picked up on the back of that, as Serenifox was already dead. Everyone was quite low, but they underestimated the damage coming on Sketch, and now they're going for this inhibitor.
Oh, Serenifox is trying to do something. Monsoon is going to get popped. Shiryu's not going to go down. Serenifox going super low, but here comes Arcane, jumps straight in front of him. Got that shield up as well to sustain a little bit of that damage. Cunning comes out to take him super low. He actually goes down. Jolsey with the charm just enables him to finish him off, and they're going to take a tower as well.
Yep, and look at that. Drake, 3 kills or 4 kills. Tower, no, 5 kills right now.
5 kills, yeah. Arcane went down twice.
5 kills. And then look at the wave in the top lane. That wave will take the tower at least halfway down.
Pain. Oh, okay. I think we're good.
There is a Maokai behind.
Oh, there is a Maokai behind. Serenity actually teleports straight on the dragon pit there. Oh, Shiny God, not again. He gets picked off. And oh, Jolsey actually goes down. Hemoplague. Coming out of nowhere there, Jolsey didn't even see her HP. Tried to spear rush away, but Hemoplague just too strong.
Yep, a little bit of redemption going in favor of the Spanish team here, but they're still silver behind, right? Look at this scoreboard just now, and we'll go from left to right. 2 dragons to 0, 5 towers to 0. It's 7,000 gold advantage and 8 kills to 6, right? So we went from the outside to inside. Italy are pressing the feathers, and this might be a desperate play. This a desperate play.
Shiny has just respawned as well. Shiryu and obviously Rengoland are near this Baron. Baron's about half HP. They're not taking it quickly at all. They're going to turn on this one possibly. Cunning comes out as well, with Sketch just trying to face off the damage. But here comes the Onslaught Shadows into 3 members, but it's not going to hit anybody. Rengoland on the backside though is going to pick up Savage. He's doing so much damage but cannot get past this Maokai. Sketch on the side though is going to pick up this Graves. Actually, I take that back. Rengoland picking up another kill, and Pain's going to go down as well. Shiny getting a little bit of redemption. Serenifox, the only last member surviving from UCM, and he's probably going to get run down as well. Sketch with a movement speed boost actually gets the flash away. Rengu land with the axes, trying to get the slows, but going to be a flash away from Serenifox. But this could be, is this going to be a turnaround Baron? It does look like they're going to try it.
Yeah, this would easily be a turnaround Baron with Janna, who still has Monsoon. Oh, she doesn't, unfortunately, but she has her shields. She will be able you'll be able to protect these guys for a while, get that extra dimension illusion, and they burn this down. But what a good team fight, right? They, even though they were 3v5, they realized we have the damage. Baron is dealing damage to them as well. He's our 4th team member for this fight. And they went for it. What happened? As soon as the damage landed from the calling, Hecarim went in, Onslaught Shadows, and Rango just went in and decided Saver is dead. There's no other option for you. He ghosted at her. He ran through with his Ragnarok, and Saver had no choice of that. He then fought Serenity Fox on his own. Shradich went down, Pain Valdi went down, and Janna came in just right at the clutch moment, right? She managed to save Sketch, add more shields to him, and this is what won them the fight. Force the 4 kills and the Baron pickup for them now. So and just over 10,000 gold lead now in favor of the Italians. They are playing. They're showing this macro play they showed yesterday, and they're really utilizing the team, right? They picking up towers, they're picking up kills, they're picking up objectives. Next dragon, what is that? I don't even know. I can't see. Mountain dragon, help them with the siege. if they manage to pick that up, I'm expecting the game to finish after within like 6 minutes. So before the next dragon spawns, that is most likely what's going to happen. They're now looking at four manning topside with the Baron buff. There is no way stopping this. Rango is going to go for this inhibitor. Damn.
Yeah, wow.
Goes down so fast. Culling popped as well. Pain's going to have to pull just to get away.
Damage.
His damage is it's just ridiculous. I mean, we talked about him being a carry last game that they played earlier the other day. Onslaught Shadows is used. I'm just completely distracted. Sketch actually picks up a kill there, and this is surely going to be over. Pain going down in the back line so low there. Shiny God pops the Monsoon as well. He's going to go down. Hegrim picking up that kill. And, man, USM just looks so dominant right now. This Hecarim pick was just absolute. It's working wonders for them, really, and Sketch is going off yet again.
Yep, and with 30 second timers, this is definitely the game. They're picking up tower after tower, and this will be the Nexus. Wow. But I'm just gonna look at this bot lane. 1-2-11 on Janna. High kill position in 7-0-5. Let me just repeat that. 7-0-5 on this Lucian. He's Grande right now, right? He's the Sketch of the game. Really winning his lane, styling on it, utilizing them all, and I'm not sure who the shot caller for the Italians is, but he's doing a great job. He's utilizing his players. He's saying, you go here, we do this at this time, and it's paying off. They now won 2 games in a row. They'll be taking sole place at the moment in the front until the next game is over.
Wow.
I'm excited. After seeing this game, I am excited. Yeah. And I'm hyped up to do more.
I'm a bit speechless, if I'm honest. And I obviously saw the Jinx play, and I was like, wow, this guy, he's pretty good on these AD carries, right? But 7-0-5 in this Lucian, just his positioning as well in the team fights was just absolutely spectacular. And this Hecarim pick, we talked about it in pregame, in the lobby, and said, you know, it has worked out for some teams, and it just hasn't. But these Italians, they got this Hecarim pick again, and they're showing that they can really utilize it, right? He's splitting up some of the team fights. The team fight around the Baron we had, just on sort of shadows, straight in the middle of them, and enabled Rengu to pick off the Sivir. Just marvelous play from them. Well, we have got another game coming up for you guys as well, so be sure to stick around. And we're going to jump to a quick break, and we'll be right back with your second game of this evening.
Two.
They just haven't seen it. Afraid of the dark, I'm gonna hold your hand. Wherever you are, let's get lost tonight. Let's go somewhere, let's get wild tonight. Let's run away from here, let's get lost tonight. Let's go somewhere, let's get wild tonight. Let's run away from here.
Hello everybody and welcome back to the third day of the University Esports Masters. My name is Jack Jaws Wright, and obviously I'm joined by Sverin Last Saber Eistat. And we are into our second game of...
Yep, and those who missed the first game, what a game have you missed, right? It's Italy versus our Spanish team. Italy went off, they went off the radar, decided to win the game near the end. Played perfectly in the macro play and managed to take the win. So they're now 2-0 on the leaderboard, leaving Spain with a 1-2 record. Somewhere in the middle is what we have now, which is Aston Antis, or Aston University from the UK, which will decide if they win this game, where they will go in the table. If they win it, they will go in first place, shared with Italy. Obviously, they have one game extra, so Italy will need to lose for it to be technically shared. But otherwise, we'll be just right there. We're almost ready into this game as well. Champions ready, so let them know. There we go. What game we have in front of us, right? It's France versus Austin, right here.
It's gonna be good. And you know, I'm straight into pick and ban phases. I have reset my client, so there's no need to worry. And we should actually see the picks this time. So, pick and ban phase are a go. Remember, this is the UK squad versus the French AUB versus ECL, and a Zac ban is going to be the first thing, the British.
Yep, and I think this is a good ban, right? They've done their research by the looks of it, because when I did my research, I saw four champions that Jin Bonobo plays, right? And two of them in the first game they played were banned out, and Zac was the third. We have Jin Bonobo, who plays Wukong, Nocturne, boom, that's another ban, and he plays Zac and Gragas, right? So those are the four champions. I'm looking forward, if they ban him out, are they gonna try to force him onto the Gragas ban because they're sure they can counter it, or are they gonna just pick the Gragas away and force him onto a champion he's not comfortable on? Following that, we do see the standard Nidalee ban coming out of the French side. They will be taking that away from Jett. I think not only Jett, but every jungler that's proficient on Nidalee is dangerous. We've seen this from Lechase on the side of Portugal. In two games, even though he did lose one of the games, he went off in it. He went crazy. Nidalee was doing plenty of damage. He went 4-0-1 at some point. So that's banned away. Followed by the Nocturne, like I called it there. So they are really targeting Bonobo here.
Yep. Just a tad. Only three jungle bans towards. But Malzahar is going to be a ban from ECL, as they do target Wood League, who had a pretty good performance last game they played. It was UK versus Spain. He went 3-0-8, I believe. So Malzahar, another one that's kind of is come out of nowhere, realistically, right? We've seen him in a lot of LCK games recently over the last couple of weeks, and he's one of those mid laners now that is more solidifying, is solidifying their place, sorry, in the mid role. But there is going to be a Gragas hover here from Matty, going over to probably Jett, as they're pretty much just completely targeting Bonobo away, really.
Maybe, I don't know, maybe they have some good analysts. No, they're taking Shen. Ooh. So Matty tries to did play on that Shen before. He managed to win against Jax in lane. So when he got his Sunfire, that's when he really started to win trades. So that'll be going in his favor again. I'm not sure what his KDA was yesterday, but he did play quite well. I've only noted the main one, which was Jett, Wood League, and MSR. So when these guys come into play, I'll then mention it. But things like Rek'Sai, that is still open, right? Rek'Sai is champion Jett really prefers. He went 4-1-7 on it yesterday. He had a good game. He had good control of the jungle. He had good control of the ganks, and that's what took him in. Now we just see a Sion hover. This is a pick we haven't seen for a while, so tell me about it.
Well, Sion could be flexed realistically into two roles. Support if you're crazy, Madman, or you can obviously pick the top lane. I mean, into a Shen pick though, what do you really think that's going to do? I mean, Shen's got more map pressure just as soon as he hits six anyway, and Sion really when he uses his ultimate, you can hear him coming from a mile off. So I think the Shen, the Saren pick into the Shen might be a little bit dangerous. But in the team fights, he's going to have a bit of a bigger impact for sure. But there's going to be a Hecarim locked away, actually, on the blue side of ECL. Don't know who's going to pick that one up. And we have seen it in the last game, and it did kind of go off.
Yeah, but we've seen both sides of the Hecarim coin, right? We've seen the good Hecarims, and we've seen the bad. We've seen Shoria go off on it, and then we've seen Shreddage just totally go... I don't even know, mediocre is the word looking here for, because he didn't get pressure, he didn't get kills. Yes, he was there, and he managed to force some flashes, but he never really got anywhere. It was like... one of those guys, you know, when you try to hit on a girl in a bar and unfortunately you get the number but you never call it. That's what he did.
That is a good analogy. I'll give you that one.
He got the number and never called it. So that's locked in. And that's a champion we still haven't seen in Bonobo. So he's been forced out of his favorite junglers there. He picks up Hecarim. So not the Gragas we expected, I think, here. Or at least not the Gragas I expected. Following by the picks from the blue team side, Austin picking up the Carmen Vladimir. So another two... high priority picks that go in favor of the blue team. This is coming out already to be a nice rounded up comp with plenty of AoE damage, plenty of that Mantra E from Karma, the Mantra Q. These will be plenty. This will be like ridiculously high damage comps or ridiculously high engage comps right here.
Yeah, and it'll be interesting to see if the Karma does flex to the support role, as she is picked up a little bit more frequently now. Obviously, with things like Vladimir. And actually, I don't know what I'm saying because Vladimir's already been locked in. I just realized that. I'm like, oh, where could Karma go? Oh, yeah, Vladimir. Unless there's Vladimir support if you know, you're crazy. But Karma will be flexed towards the support role as Lucian is hovered. But a Jinx and Thresh being locked away for ECL as well. Now, they didn't play this in their last game. They played Caitlyn Morgana, a bit more of a passive lane. And... By the looks of this draft already, coming out from the French, they really want to get this Jinx snowboarding, right? So, Hecarim coming into lane quite early with this Ghost, and the Thresh to make the plays with the Flash Ignite. Possibly can go through. Obviously, you can take the Exhaust as well. Lucian and Blitzcrank, though, locked away for the blue side. I'm assuming Blitzcrank is a placeholder, unless it's Blitzcrank jungle.
No, correct. Blitzcrank is a placeholder. It's a placeholder for Rek'Sai here. Okay. So, a nice round of that team comp. Two tanks front lane, Karma to engage them, and Vladimir Lucian to the damage. Really nicely well rounded up comp, and they'll be going for these AoE fights. The lanes are also strong, right? Shen doesn't usually lose lane, and Vladimir will hold off, you'll be able to farm. I'm not sure if his counterpart from the side of the French are here, but we do have the sign. We do have the Jinx Thresh bot lane, so he has a little of the defense with the lantern. Death Sentence is going to be there. I want to see if he can be another a French mad life here.
The French mad life. Well, I'm kind of disappointed on Augusty Blitz jungle, but hey, I mean, you could invade level 1, technically, and then just hook the Gromp and smite it away, then walk away. Like, that would be my tactic as a Blitz jungle, but unfortunately, it's not going to happen, as it does look like Ahri is going to get locked away for the second time this evening. Blood Evil's taking that one. So we are going to skip back to the lobby real quick, as the game is just remade, and obviously Rek'Sai coming into the jungle here. Or Jet. And now he did play it last, the game previous, their time versus Spain, and 4-1-7, I believe, he went on that.
Yep, so a really good KDA for him. And one thing I want to mention, we do have a mirror matchup in the mid lane again. We saw that last game, and that went in favor of the Ahri. So I want to see if Blood Evils is comfortable on the Ahri. I'm just going to quickly stalk his profile. Yes, he is. He's proficient. He's one of his top play champions. But we're gonna... You see when you said Blitzcrank jungle, I was actually thinking Karma jungle.
Karma Trid, jungle, hey, come
Trid
on.
Just called it as well, but Trid is a god at calling it. So am I. Yesterday I made the call insanely well. I'm surprised with myself. I literally bowed down in front of the mirror to respect.
damn.
But we see the picks coming through now, so we're gonna head into our 3-minute delay. Unfortunately, we're not LCS. We don't have the protection value.
Yes.
To be casting live. Don't want to spoil the game for some people.
True. Oh well, we're just going to have to... People are just going to have to sit and listen to our lovely voices for the next 3 minutes as we do go into the game. Or four, I mean, there's a countdown now. But Karma Lucian into this bottom lane duo of the Jinx Thresh. Now it seems to me, both of these lanes, especially on ECL side with the Hecarim, right? They want to go aggressive early to get this Jinx ahead. But... Karma with her mass disengage and mass engage, Mantra Inspire, and then Lucian just with a ridiculous amount of damage early game, with even just half an item. Rated Dirk, for example. They're going to want to go aggressive too. So this, like last game, I think, is going to be a bloodbath. And not just because Vladimir's on the other team.
Yep, and I'm going to be focusing on PLC on this Jinx. Because of the hype Italians put me through, right? They played this Jinx insanely. They had a really good comp to defend it. The only difference is now they're playing Thresh instead of Braum. And obviously a different top laner. But Sion, I think he's a protector. He's the gatekeeper of the top lane, right? He will shoot you right into your back line. And if not, he'll just sit in the front and not let you pass. He's like a mix of Gandalf and and all these other movie characters, I can say, that protect the gates.
Gandalf and... I can't think of anything else. Protect the gates.
A trick to G Gandalf. That's what he does.
Trick to G Gandalf. That's Gandalf 2G. He needs to change his name right this second to Gandalf 2G. But if he can be that wall, as you say, against this Shen, obviously Shen with a Stan United, I think the matchup in the top lane is going to go fairly just non-eventful is the word I'm looking for, in the early game at least. Do you think, again, these junglers are really going to focus this this mid and bottom side?
Definitely. Jerry's going to try to go for it. Yeah, he might go for one or two ganks on Blood Evils to get Wood League rolling. I was going to call him Blood League because of Vladimir, of course. But he might go for that. I don't think top lane is going to be its own island, right? It's going to be the lonely island in the top lane. They're going to just stay, and they're going to be singing I'm on a Boat together.
Oh, I was just about to make that reference.
No,
man.
It's my reference. Oh. See, I am the freak of this cast right now.
God.
Puns right. are mine. But yeah, they'll be singing songs in themselves, farming away. But I think it goes in favor of Matty a little bit. He does have the Stand United. He does have the teleport, so that's double for him. We then have Vladimir of Ghost, so that can help him if he needs to roam down bot lane. And they obviously they'll just go for these fights. Rek'Sai, we seen Jett yesterday when he got ahead. He didn't actually go for the Cinderhulk first. He went for this Tiamat to get his jungle pushing better. He forced these fights and he dealt plenty of damage to these squishy targets early on.
We'll see if he does go that route again, if he wants to be aggressive. And Vladimir and Ahri, again, you said a minute ago it's going to be a mirror matchup yet again. So it'll be interesting to see how these two players differ in their abilities. Obviously, Ahri did kind of dominate last game in the lane, just constantly harassing this Vlad, pushing him in, just making sure he wasn't able to dive at any point. Obviously, taking the Ghost and Ignite like last game, but not going to be a Sivir, which makes me a little bit sad. I love seeing Sivir in team comps because, you know, as soon as she's near at least a couple of members, there's going to be a fight just through her ultimate. And seeing it with Hecarim as well is just hilarious because he just does so much damage. I mean, we saw him last game with the Cinderhulk and he built into a Sheen. And just with the Sheen, like no Trinity Force, just Sheen, which is just doing so much damage to that Gravespick. But Rek'Sai, I think, is going to be a little bit safer just because he's going to be a little bit more tanky.
Yep, and one thing we sort of didn't like is the amount of CC on each fight, right? You have Sion's Q, you have Sion's Ultimate, you have Hecarim Devastating Charge, you have Onslaught of Shadows, Spirit Rush with the Charm, you have Chompers from Jinx, Death Sentence. There's so much CC right now on the side of the French team, but one thing I wanna point out here is Jett likes to gank from behind, right? Especially in the bot lane, he likes to come from Tribush and get that tower dive. And what an easier target than a Jinx, an immobile champion that has to stay close unless she uses her rocket and wastes some mana. And so this is what he's gonna be looking for. I'm not sure if PLB is safe here.
We'll see if he can make it through the early game as we do load up onto the Rift very momentarily as we do hit the loading screen. Beautiful. And so what are your predictions? I mean, both these teams, very teamfight centric. Vladimir, obviously, with the Karma Mantra and Spire is going to be quite proficient in the way they're going to enable the Vladimir to get multi-man Hemo Plagues, which is going to enable him to get the heal. But like you said, on the French side, they have just so much CC. So, I mean, is it going to be a case of just a kind of standoff around these objectives and wait until the first team makes a mistake? Or are we going to look for more coordinated dives in the early game from this Hecarim?
Yeah, I'm looking forward to. I think it's Aston that's going to be making the plays in this game. I'm going to try not to sound as biased because obviously it is an English team. I am an English caster, but I'm going to try to sound unbiased. Judging by the appearances in the previous games, Aston had a bad shaky start, but they managed to pick up the Spanish team who beat France, right? So just by that, it's France is less than Spain, is less than UK, leaving a little bit of differential there. They also played quite well. They have a around the team comp, which they played before. They had the submarine combo right there. Matty Triceps and Jet will be coming in with that. And one combo landed yesterday, and that is literally the snowball that started the win for our University of Birmingham here. That's where I'll be looking. Level 6, straight away, it's going to be interesting to see if they manage to do it, if the submarine works, and where they're going to use the submarine. Most likely it's going to be on POB, and Zedek is in the bottom lane, so these guys should be paying attention. Maybe Bonobo might try to, you know, look for these counter ganks. But overall, I'm a little bit edged towards this Austin win.
Oh, we'll see. Unfortunately, he's not wearing the pool party Rek'Sai skin. He would be truly a submarine. Oh. But see, I can make puns too. Ha ha ha. But they are going to look to start both on the top side. Both junglers are going to start on the top side, like before. Bit of a switch up. We normally obviously see a lot of junglers starting on the bottom side just to try and push towards this mid top. But if they do make the early ganks, obviously, they will have the level advantage there. So, Jet on the Rek'Sai and beautiful. Another pause.
Yeah, this is called before. Unfortunately, on the friend side, there is a little bit of connection issues for Zedekus. So, he did call it. He said it's going to be about 15-30 seconds of connection issues once in a while. So these pauses are this beautiful sepia scenery right now of Hecarim killing the Krug.
Beautiful.
This is League Photography 2K16, guys. This should be a new contest. If anyone puts it into Riot and I see it there, I will sue you for copyright. I'm just kidding.
I'd put it on my wall that way.
I've already stolen Ellie's or Scarecrow's lines earlier, so.
Well, fortunately.
Oh, I forgot to mention, MSR has his Mastery Spam again.
Great. Mastery Spam. That's the best thing in League of Legends. More emotes to spam. I missed the Worlds ones, where the Worlds icons would come up. If you had the specific Worlds.
Or the Fire and Ice ones, definitely.
Oh, they were
those
cool.
Those were really cool, yeah.
Yeah, goddamn. I wish they'd bring that stuff back.
Yeah. So we're seeing pretty standard lane swaps, camps being finished. Rek'Sai is actually leaving the blue buff till later. I'm not sure why. Maybe he's just trying to stop the counter and if there was an invade happening on his red. So he's protecting that. He went straight there. He'll be doing his camps.
Oh, and break going really good here. Matty Tristop's actually forced the flash out of him as well. Jeez, that Grassy Undying, even though it was nerfed, still does a lot of damage. And Matty Triceps, like you said in pregame, actually, he's really sticking it to Unbreak.
Yep, and look at this. Jinx actually going for the early push, getting punished a little bit. And this is the opposite of what we saw last game, right? Bloody Wolves is getting punished on the Ahri by this Vladimir. So Woodleak already proving a little bit of dominance, forcing at least one potion to be used. And this is the good thing against ranged champions, right? He went with this Doran shield to stop the auto attack damage, which is Ahri's main poke.
Oh, here comes Jet for the first engage. Flash on Burrow on Zedekus. Zedekus going so low. He'll be in profit from Jinx as well. But here comes Bonobo straight onto Jet. MSR, they're all so low. Bonobo's almost full HP. Flash forward from Jinx to try and get a kill. That's going to be one. That's going to be two. Picking up Jet, trying to escape. A red buff on him. Does get zapped. He might be able to get the Umbro. One rocket through. It's not going to connect. Well, it does connect, but doesn't get the kill. Beautiful counter engage there from Bonobo. Two kills to one now.
Yep,
over on the side of ECL.
One of them goes to Jinx, which is a really good target for him to be in. Unfortunately, the first bat did go in favor of MSR, so he still has the short lead in gold. I lied, he's 100 gold behind. But he's still there. He managed to pick up the call for himself. So he's going for the slower start here. They're trying to pick up the extra gold from, you know, 100 CS is a good pickup of 300 extra gold. We also see the Edric on the bottom side. So a good try of a gank.
Whoa.
Cool.
Okay, we're good. You can carry on now.
No, yeah, no, I'll break. I'll say Vladimir went for the Matrix play there.
Yeah, like
he was the Neo, Hecarim was the bullets, right?
God damn. All right, you're the reference king. Fine. I'll give you that crown back.
There you go. That was actually a metaphor, not a pun, so I'll stick with it.
Oh, that was my bad then. Terrible.
No worries.
Pastor.
No, it's fine. We're killing it here.
Well, Wood League. Putting the pain to Blood Evils. Then Blood Evils. Uh-oh, hang on a minute. Unbreak. Might be a little bit of caught here. Yet. He's in the top side. Oh, here comes Bonobo. Charges straight. Look at that damage. That is insane. Bonobo picking up another kill. Matty Tricep's in a little bit of trouble as well. Unbreak. They might not want to go for a tower dive. They're still pretty low levels. And Bonobo again. Just being all around the map and picking up another kill.
Yep, and even though he didn't have so much pressure on the Gragas, he's been banned at, he's still causing so much havoc on the Hecarim. He's 700 gold ahead of Jet, he 2 kills ahead, so he's and 9 CS as well. So he's going to be stealing this blue buff as well, so which Rek'Sai left open for too late. Yeah, and they don't know about this, so this is a giant 3 buff advantage, 2 kills with the Hecarim, and Bonobo is the force they need right now for him to start snowballing. This Jinx, start snowballing this Ahri. Look at this, he's coming. Oh, he's killing Skullcrab.
Oh. Well, I trust in Wood League's Matrix ability. The pool. Andy and MSR not having too much of a fun time in the bottom lane either. Does look like Jinx is going for the first item, Hurricane. Just to try and clear the waves a little bit quicker. Wasting a little bit less mana, obviously, those rockets. Cost a fair bit early game.
Yep, and we're just going to see the small advantage of 1,000 gold in the, in the words of Donald Trump, a small loan of 1,000 gold. But it's nothing to panic about yet. It's 6 minutes into the game. This is something they can easily bring back, especially when Lucian gets his items. If they manage to land these Karma Lucian combos, especially on the Jinx, it could mean death, unless the death sentence lands. So these are going to be interesting fights, interesting. You know, skirmishes between these team fights. Again, Sion and Shen, this is not going to be something specific, but again, when the submarine comes, Matty Tresor thus has it level 6 now, and there's Hema Plague on the Wood League. Karma has an inbuilt level 6, so that's fine for her as well. And this is going to be explosive. That's when I think, Austin is going to try and pick up these kills. They're going to try and get these team fights because they do have a good team fight in comp here.
Yep, they do indeed. Vladimir with the Hema Plague plus Andy with the engage. Would be pretty devastating. It landed on more than a couple of members. Matty Triceps now punishing in the early game. Now getting a little bit punished. Obviously six now as well. Stan United is available. See if he does want to make a play at some point towards this bottom side or mid. And Wood League is pushing up Ahri in the mid lane yet again. Ahri's zero mana now. She's going to have to back off, but does like a gank in the mid lane again. Doesn't use the Matrix this time. Bonobo jumps straight onto Wood League. Not too much damage, though. Hemoplague coming out. Oh, no. Hemoplague is available. There comes the Stan United. He might want to turn this one around. Devastating charge coming through and the ultimate, but no, this could be a turnaround. Hemoplague down onto Bonobo. He's going so low. Will he be able to survive? Yes, he will. Ghost used as well. Unbreaking a little bit of trouble now. Has got the flash. Does use it to get away. Matty Triceps to the rescue. In this bottom, in this mid side.
Yep, and they managed to defend this fight. It popped Ghost from Hecarim, popped Flash from Sion. Yes, they did take Wood League's both summoners, but they almost lost the fight in a 2v2, right? Ahri had to back off, and this could have been a grave mistake for them. If they managed to lose there and get this Vladimir rolling, it might have caused a big havoc because the Hema Plague does plenty of damage later in the game.
Does indeed. Blood Evil just trying to. Alright, this pink ward near the dragon. And again, dragon is going to be a cloud drake to start off with. Not the most entertaining dragon, but definitely going to be kind of handy inside of ESL.
Andy,
Didicus. Taking a lot of damage from the Mantra Q. And Jet finally scoring the drop off as well. Jet hasn't had a good time, really, in this jungle already. 10 CS behind and a couple of kills on his counterpart of Bonobo. Not a fun time.
Yeah, and it's still 1,000 gold. It's still 1,000 gold in favor of them. There's nothing really changing. CS differentials are the same, and no kills have been picked up. So it's gonna be one of these objectives that we really start seeing differences, right? Everyone except MSR now and Zedekus has their ultimates, and so this is just a slow waiting game until they pick that off and they try to do these team fights. Laning phase, we're not gonna see too much action unless Jet or Bonobo come in to interfere again. But where are they gonna come to interfere? Jet is most likely gonna focus on PLB because Ahri has Spear Rush, so he can always dash away and this is just not gonna be a problem. Whereas Bonobo is gonna be looking at this mid lane to pick off this Vlad or even bot lane. He can pull a sneaky bush gank just coming through the lane.
Yeah, Onslaught Shadows. quite devastating, along with the devastating charge as well. It does look like he's going to go towards the mid lane, though. Woodling in a little bit of trouble, possibly. Vanidal does use the ultimate. Yeah, he's going to get in there. Ignite as well. The healing's going to be reduced. That's going to be an easy kill. Flashing away. No, the tower hit just clips him. And that's going to be a trade in the mid lane. The kill actually going over to Bonobo there.
Yep, so you might kill another kill for Bonobo, but another kill in return for...
Ooh, yeah, actually wants something. Oh, no. No, he doesn't.
And this is the build I was talking about. Skirmisher, Saber, and Tiamat. So even though he's not ahead, he's going for this offensive. Let's catch up. Let's farm quicker than you. And I'll try to catch up, make sure I'll be able to make plays and deal plenty of damage while still maintaining his survivability. It's a Rexxer at the end of the day. The champion is... There's a reason it's most picked for its mobility and build and tankiness. And look what he's doing. He's going to be picking this off, and I bet you he's going to go into the Tribush and try to pick off another dive onto the tower, onto the Jinx.
If he can make that dream a reality.
Gonna be spotted by the ward? No?
Oh, no, he's going behind the tower. Nice sneaky gank. A lot of Rek'Sai's do this. Dedicus. PLB, they know something's up. Here comes submarine. The Shen, though. The submarine's coming in. PLB actually dives straight over that. No, the flash isn't going to work. Matty Triceps comes down, secures the kill. Zedekus in a lot of trouble as well. That's going to be a lot of tower hits on Matty Triceps. A kill goes straight over to MSR, and that's going to be a pause in the middle. Oh, man. What what a time to pause. Umbreak ulting into MSR. MSR in midair. Oh, dear.
My, I changed my camera. I was actually watching the Shen because he's on single digit HP right now.
Oh, red bar just flashing over there. Yeah, he did have to flash out. He did take tower aggro, so he took about maybe 2-3 hits. And he does have to flash out. But they are going to pick off the bottom lane of ECL by the looks of it. And Ari did DC, so she's only just walking back to mid lane. But MSR, realistically, I think he's going to be able to get out of this one. It does have Flash Heal available, and obviously Jet is there as well. So hopefully they should be able to turn that one around.
Yeah, I think they'll look for the turnaround because Andy is there. Sion has very little mana. The player we should be looking at is if Shen can escape. There is one single melee minion chasing him with his single digit HP. But we are in pause because of this Ahri. Unfortunately, this is not a good pause for them. They will fall a little bit behind. We're picking up the 4 kills, though. They've now closed the gap. Sorry, the 2 kills. They've closed the gap of the gold. They might be picking up the 3rd one, which will give them lead. And they might even pick up a tower here, because there's no one to deal with it, right? Vladimir is forcing this area in the middle. Sion is at the bottom, and Hecarim is still at base. So before he pops his ghost and starts beating her, he won't be able to have so much pressure on the game.
Yeah, we'll see if they can take this bottom tower. Like you said, Shen is at a single-digit HP, so he might just want to back just in case... A rogue minion decides to throw a little.
He is on 7 HP.
7 HP. That's pretty close to death. That's. I think that is called lucky. I mean, I don't like to throw the word around luck. I don't like to throw the word luck around a lot, but he's going to get back into the game. Andy is going to be able to, chain up Unbreak there as well. He's going to go so low. MSR actually might want to dive this one. Spire there. He's going to flash and he's going to get the kill. Quite easy. Is he going to survive? Oh, heal just to save me. He's all right.
2 times in 2 games, Lucian's about to die, and he just pops the heal right as the tower pops.
Psych! Pops the heal, runs away, but...
Look at this.
Rocket! Jinx! Not even close.
But we are now at 5-4. The gold lead has gone in favor of Aston, and they are taking charge of this game. 3 kills on MSR, right? This is what we wanted to see. He's 600 go ahead. And this is the MSR we saw yesterday against Spain. That is a lot of damage going on to this Ahri.
Yep. Too much damage. Bonobo looking round. And like you said, yeah, Lucian, he did perform the other day as well versus Spain. 6-1-3 he ended with the Lucian. We'll see if he can mirror that score this game. Wood League again, just pushing Blood Evils in. But oh, hang on a minute. Oh, he went for the Matrix, the Psych! Bonobo's here as well. Hasn't got ultimate available, so... Oh, Devastating Charge, yes, he does have Onslaught of Shadows available. Ghost being popped as well by Wood League. Here comes Jet to the rescue, though. Bonobo does back off, does use the Ghost as well. Now, Hemoplague and Devastating Charge. Sorry, Onslaught of Shadows. Keep getting those names mixed up. PLB going low as well. MSR being caught up in the traps, though. The hook comes through. Does land. The flay comes as well. PLB might be able to pick up another kill. Exhaust. Zedekus is actually going to secure that one there. Jinx gets excited. And he's really low. Level 7 on her. Does get the flash. The zap follows through. Doesn't hit. But that's still going to be another kill for ECL's bot lane.
Yep, so they managed to pick up a consolation prize in the bottom lane for the play in the middle they weren't able to go. And 600 gold lead instantly picked up from that, right? Because they did manage to get the Shadow Gold onto Lucian. And they managed to kill him off, which was a really good fight. That's the heal he used on the tower to survive, cost him this fight as well. So they might be looking forward into... They will be taking clearing some vision here, and they might be looking at picking up this dragon here, if Hecarim does roam down.
Well, he's just spawned now, and Onslaught of Shadows on such a low cooldown, and by the time he ganks again, he'd probably have that one available. Stan United available too, though. See what he can do. Jett coming in the mid lane. Bloody was might be in a little bit of trouble. Does Charmed yet to get away. No ult available from her either. Flash as well. So she's just using the Q to get a bit of movement speed. Here comes Bonobo to the rescue, though. Does look like AUB are just going to walk away from this one.
Yeah, but Hemoplague is still on cooldown, same as Bait Rush. So not really a lot that can happen. Summoner's down because of the fight in the middle earlier. And this was just a little bit of a dead chase coming in. Bonobo showed himself and they instantly backed off. Vision-wise, none of the teams are really spectacular. There is one pink ward, some of them being cleared from each side. A little bit of a deep jungle vision, not even entry vision into the enemy jungle from Andy here, but that's the best. So it's not really good vision. Bonobo can't be spotted quite easily. Obviously, they know he's on the top side because Jett saw them there, but Jett is now looking forward to clearing these cloaks and most likely going bot again or even trying to solo this cloud break.
Yep, PLB and Zedekus are fairly far in the lane. The wave is pushing, though, so they should be all right, but he is going to look... Doesn't look like Jett's actually going to go for the back route again, but there is a ward there, and Bonobo is on the blue side jungle as well, so should be okay on the side of ECL if the gank does come around because they've got a lot of backup, but... Matty Triceps, like I said, Stan United is available. Bonobo looking for him. Jett is spotted. Devastating Charge is used. Jett just tunnels away, though. It's not going to be a problem. And just like they're just going to reset. And Cloudrake still not contested either.
Yeah, this is something they're not looking forward to picking up. And maybe they'll look at it at about the 16-minute mark. But that's the best I'm expecting at them. Just to run down the lane, look at the differentials in CS right now. 20 CS in the lead for Jinx, 20 CS in the lead for Sion, but 30 CS behind in favor of this Vladimir. Is it 30? Or yeah, it's 30, right? No, 20. There you go. God, my maths, after this hot weather, it gets hard.
Forget maths. Wow. Andy may be a little bit dead, goes onto tower. Stan United is used though, but Bonobo's easily going to be able to pick up that kill. That is an ultimate used as well on the side of Matty Triceps. Andy didn't stand a chance there. Flash and Burrow from Jett though is going to jump on PLB. Teleport down from Sion. We'll see if he can make anything of this. No, MSR's just going to jump forward. Zedekus gets the hood on Woodley. Good charm as well from the Ahri, who does join the fight in the bottom side. The Wood League is going to be able to sustain up, not a problem. So beautiful pick on PLB there from the Austin Aunties. Jett looking for Blood Evil's good charm to stop the Unburrow. Blood Evil should be fine to back away, but it does look like it's going to be a tower going over to AUB and possibly even a dragon.
Yep, so we're going to see a first objective of the game fall down, which will be this tower in the bottom lane at about 16 minutes now. And a gold lead going back in favor of Austin here, right? They're picking up that. There's one gold advantage, 1,000 gold advantage, and that Donald Trump loan. I'm gonna repeat myself because I love that quote.
Oh, yeah. You
know, smaller than $1 million. But,
good meme, man.
There was some memeing going on in the top lane, right? Shen tried to use Stand United, Sion cancelled his...
Oh.
He's cancelled. See, there's memeing. That's what they're doing right now. They're memeing each other. But Sion ulted, popped the hype train, went choo-choo, stopped Shen from teleporting, right? Then he tried to teleport himself. Matty tried to match it. He cancelled it. So they were just messing around with this fight because there was no need for them to teleport. So they stayed back in this lane. Really, three abilities that are able to for them to travel across the map, neither of them went through.
Nope. Denied. Across the map. Does it like there's a lane swap coming out from AUB. MSR and Andy are going to go towards this top side as the bottom tower, tier 1 at least, is down for ECL. So Matty is going to be towards the bottom side now. He's going to have to deal with PLB though, and Zedekus, but he shouldn't have too much problems. He is a Shen after all. Jett looking towards this top side.
I think he's mostly just going there to defend the lane from being pushed while they get the top tower. And this is the same thing we saw last game, right? They picked up the bottom tower and it's a hook onto Jett.
Oh, nice hook on Jett there. He's going to get flayed back onto tower. Here comes Bonobo. He has got Onslaught of Shadows available, but Andy's actually going to stun him up there. MSR doing so much damage. This early game power spike from Lucian just doing so much work. And Unbreak as well going super low. That armor pen really Really just chunking through Umbreak's HP, but they are going to be able to fend off this wave quite easily. Woodley coming in as well. Oh, Zedekus is caught on the wrong side of the tower. Hemoplate going down, but that's going to be Exhaust as well. He's going to get hooked. Bonobo, Woodley is completely caught out here. Blood Eva's going to join the fight. Jinx Rosa completely misses. They're just going to use the ultimate from Hegron to finish up the kill. Blood Evils is going to be able to secure that one.
And why did Shen not use his ultimate there? He had Standing United available. He could have easily tried to save it and gave Woodleague enough time to pick off some kills just before he died, right? Unfortunately, that's not where it goes. They lose a kill, and that's like this is a turnaround siege, but they are quite low. Let's see what they do here. Karma has their Mantra Q.
Whoa. Umbreak. Yeah, whoa, hang on a minute. Pretty low, buddy. Does back off. Has to flash away, though. Andy trying to get some snipers in, but actually gets charmed. Hook coming out from Zedekus. Nice flash, though, but Bonobo comes around from the side. But Matty Tristops with the ultimate. MSR's going to be able to secure that kill. He's going to be able to secure another one. Double kill. Nice turnaround. Umbreak going really low as well. Good turnaround here from AUB. Are they going to look to dive? No, they are not. Blood Evils is going to be able to back away with a speed boost from the orb. A beautiful Stan United coming out from Matty Tristops. Secures AUB two more kills. Both of them going on MSR.
Yep, and this is a 5-2 Lucian. MSR proving himself on AD carries yesterday. He's proving himself today again. And this is all thanks to his teammate. He has the Karma to set him up. He has the Shen to protect him. And the Jet on the right side to Sander and just beat at his command. They now pick off Rift Herald. They're going to go for this push. They force Sand to teleport to this lane, right? Whereas Shen still has his teleport available. He can easily walk into the mid lane or anywhere he pleases. Because Vladimir Woodleague actually realized that Jinx was trying to push and stopped it, right? He went bot. He's now pushing out the lane. And they're roaming quite a little bit here, right? Lucian, MSR. Forced to back away again, has to reset. But we're seeing a little bit more objective play. They picked up one tower and they might lose the middle one in that case, though.
Yep, Jet is here for the defense. Not going to be able to do much. Only going out with a couple of praise seekers. MSR might be a little bit of trouble. Zedekus coming through, though. Ghostbait is pop. Here comes the Rek'Sai, though. Jet's going to join the fight. Zedekus on the wrong side of the tower. And he's going to come as well. Nice hook, nice try. But unfortunately, he will go down. MSR probably going to be able to pick up that kill. Yes, he is. Nice dive there, but answered by Jet using that Void Rush to easily get into lane.
There was hope for that dive, but unfortunately, Sion was just taking so much damage without landing any skill shot. MSR uses mobility to dodge everything, and now look who's
Wood League, though. Oh, nice pull again. Matching under that one. Devastating Charge used on a minion, but he's still going really low. Hemoplate popped on Ahri, and Hegron not going to be enough. Blood Evils again picking him up. Didn't even use Ignite that time, but the Morella Nemicon is going to chunk Vladimir's healing a fair bit, and they are going to take a tower for that as well. But it's going to be a trade for AUB as they do take the tier 1 in the top side.
Yep, and Sion, you're way too close to hell right now. If you stand closer, you will die. But we did see Woodleague, he got a bit too brave there, paid the price, and he's not really performing the way he was performing yesterday. He's 1-3-0. Yes, he has the CS lead, but it's not really helping him. We have to wait. It's not a good matchup for him against an Ahri because she can Spirit Dash, because he doesn't have the Proto Belt to close the gap. And that's the problem with Dial, shorting the AP ratios down in favor of, you know, because the Proto Belt is not a good, not the best item. You have the Spirit Visage, you have the Rylai's. And look at this, this is the power of the Jinx. Like, if you leave her at the split push, she has now a 40 assist lead and she'll be picking up another tower. This is evening at the towers and closing the gold lead now. It's only about 1,000, yeah, not even 600 gold differential between the two teams.
And we'll see if AB can use that to their advantage. Two towers to two, however, as the mid tower is still standing for ECL. So it seems like AUB are going to probably posture around that to open a lot of the mid map up and just put a little bit more pressure on them. But like you said, this Jinx, she's so well farmed, but Lucian has got the 6 kills. Hitting his power spike of the Ghost Blade and Black Cleaver as well as they do posture around this dragon.
Yeah, but he's about 1,000... Yeah, he's about 1,000 ahead still, even with that 30 CS deficit on him. So again, I'm hoping they finally go for the Drake. It's 22 minutes into the game and not even one dragon has died. Baron is just chilling already. He's like, guys, come pick me up.
Use
the Mountain Drake stacks on me, but no, there's no Mountain Drakes even spawn this edge.
Whoa. Well, Baron turns into a train and just runs away. Yep. Not the best use of his ultimate, but does get him out of dodge. Didn't have flash, so might have been in a little bit of trouble. Void Rush down for Jet, though, but he is going to look towards this mid lane. So three other members from AUB are going to...
And look at that positioning. Too. They'll be able to get there before anyone, and Jet is behind them.
Yep.
Jet. Tower.
going to be there. Free tower indeed. And they do just pick that one up. All tier ones now down for ESL. That's going to be a little bit easier for AUB to look towards these objectives.
Yeah, and they might go for it. Save the dragon, you know. We don't want to be singing Celine Dion songs all by myself, you know. Dragon, you are there. You are there to be killed, and you'll be providing some movement speed.
Yeah, they're going for it.
Yes, Aston.
Hey, 22 minutes, almost 23. First dragon, but beating to the rotation here. ECL, Mantra Inspire used by Andy there. Bloody was might be a little bit caught out, but no, Q's going to be enough, although Bonobo, nice ultimate through four members, but Culling's going to come out. That is going to be a spirit rush from Ari to just try and get away. Actually, Stan United used on top of him. Nice double bomb burrow. PLB has to flash out there, but MSR's quick on his heels, and she's going to go down. That's another kill. Jet picking up that one. Beautiful turnaround there from AUB, just collapsing completely and saving their tower.
And Bonobo stayed so long because he wanted to pick up the tower, but the tower survives with 300 HP. I think there is a little bit regen on these towers. I'm not quite sure. It's been so long. No, there is. Okay, that's fine. But they do pick up that kill, and now they're going to reverse it, right? Two dead, about 20 second timers, and it's only Sion and Thresh to defend. Hecarim's coming in now, but I'm not sure if he can do anything.
Oh, hook on Woodley. Here comes Hecarim. He's in as well. He's going to have to use the pool straight under the Thresh box, but Mantra Inspire yet again is just going to lead AUB to safety. The gold lead is stretched. Another 2k in the favour of AUB. So slowly increasing it. And Baron looking like a very tasty objective at the moment.
Yep, and this will be a big back for Woodley. Right, there you go. He just bought the Rylai's. He had 2,500 gold in his inventory. And so he'll be finishing his second item to Ari's unfinished, just the Morellos, right? And she has managed to finish Boots, but that's about it. And it was a good detection. They managed to realize, okay, we can deter them away from the start. Let's pop the boxes. This, and they managed to get it. So they save the second tier, and we're going back into this stalemate. We'll be looking into fights again. Hecarim has finished his Triforce. He hasn't finished his jungle item, which is quite surprising because that is such a core item. Usually people tend to go for it first and then go for the Triforce to get that power spike later on. But he chose to go for the Triforce, and now he's not as tanky as he should be.
Oh, Windhulk almost finished, but not quite there, like you mentioned. But there's like Ardent Sensor for Andy as well, so that's going to be a lot of shields coming out from her. Wood League is here, and yet again, Sion. Was that an ult from Sion? No, it was not. Oh, yes, it was. Yes, he did ult away again. So, unfortunately, he's just not using these ultimates to great effect at the moment.
And he should be using them to engage. Unfortunately, he doesn't want to leave his team, and he has to protect the star against Shen. And now this poses an engage on the Jinx.
Oh, PLB. But no, Zedekus is in the bush. Jet does get an uproot, though, but a huge hemo plague. Four members. Zedefix trying to get something, but doesn't get anything. Hooks a minion instead. MSR, another kill for you, my friend. As Matty Tricep, Stan United again available, so they can use that fairly easily, but they're just going to have a tank fight in the bottom lane. Not too much happening for them, but beautiful pick-off of Zedekus there from AUB.
It's just a shame they cannot really go for anything in them. Is this a Baron call or is this a trap call here?
Well, I don't know. They're all hiding in this bush. Bonobo is on to the side, and Blood Evils, they do spot it. So this could be a sneaky Baron. No wards actually around here from ECL, and they do look like they're going to start it up.
Yeah, but Hecarim's already on the case. Ari's behind them.
Oh, maybe not.
No, they just bluff us. That's what they do.
They bluff.
But University of Birmingham, Aston Abdi's are in the lead. They have increased the gold lead to about 4,000 now. Shen is slowly just tucking away at the start, you know. Trying to beat up a strong threat like that is not going to kill it fast. It's so fist and a small sword.
Well, Bonomo might be able to turn the tables here. Matty Triceps is in a little bit of trouble. Nice double taunt there. He won't be able to get over the wall with it, however. But Bonobo doing a lot of damage now with Serrated Duck as well. Didn't even finish the jungle arm, like you said. But he can't, unfortunately, stand United to himself. But they are just going to slowly whittle him down. Will he be able to get the dash over the wall? No, he will not. But MSR caught in the pit. There's a Baron actually getting started up. Jinx actually firing so many rockets in there. But it's actually going to be a Baron taken over by AUB. Because they do secure that one. Jinx doing a lot of damage on the sidelines, but they easily are going to be able to escape and secure that one at 27 minutes.
Oh my god, what a good call out of Aston, right? They realize Hecarim is bot lane. They realize they're trying to kill the Shen. Shen's buying time. He wasn't even trying to escape. Excuse me. I'm so excited I choked.
Happens to the best of us.
Yeah, but he was just like, okay, guys, I'm buying you time. Go for this Baron. They do not have a jungler, so it'll be a 3v5 or 3v4 in the top lane. And if anything, I can teleport back up. So he's like, I'm buying time. I'll taunt them in. I'll try to muck around. He just ran around this thing, the flashing over the wall. You see, when he ran to the wall, that's when they made the call, buy time. Because I think he was trying to flash to escape. But they were like, no, we're starting Baron. Just stay there and try to survive. He flashed over the wall later on to the river, survived, and they pick up Baron. So Baron of 5 members, 4,000 advantage, Dragon spawning in 50 seconds, and a driving seat for Aston here.
Yep, firmly in the driving seat. MSR is getting furiously pinged out by his team. Anti-triceps again on the top lane on break as well. But look like AUB are going towards this mid-tier 2 turret. They are rotating, but does look like MSR was actually just pushing up this bottom side. So again, Stan United available for Shen, not even a TP for Unbreak. So he really cannot leave this lane. Rainbow being spotted out in the sidelines here as well. So really not looking good for ECL at all. Baron buff and 5 members, like you said.
Yep, and Aston should be looking to do something. So before the Sand TP comes up, before these flashes and all these other summoners come up for Ahri, they really want to try to make something play. They're now just like relying on that cannon minion until the next wave comes in.
They're pushing 3 towers at once. Wood League's in the mid lane. There's 3. They're doing a 1-1-3 push here to great effect. Really, those Baron minions are doing a lot of damage to those towers. The next dragon is available. It's going to be an Ocean Drake as well. So again, kind of boring dragons today, but hey. Can't expect the world. But some pretty exciting games. That's going to be a tier 2 tower in the bottom lane down the ECL. AUB are going to be able to secure that one pretty easily. And it does look like a rotate to mid.
Well. Yeah, the middle one will fall before they even get there. So this might be a siege here. Enter the base because Sion just can't move. Or they're going to go for the dive.
Go for the dive. Just look like they're going to ping out. Sion's got ultimate available to escape if she really wants to. But Jett, Prey Seeker straight over the wall. And yeah, it doesn't like... They're using this Baron buff minion... Baron buff even to such great effect. Matty just tanking tower. And he's taking negative damage as well.
Yep, Baron literally just gave them 3 out of the turrets. Really nice push. Split it 1-3-1. Sion couldn't do it with... None of the solo laners could deal with the counterparts. Matty is just ahead. He has 2 armor items, a spirit visage on top of that, and Merc Tread, so he's definitely becoming a tanky menace. And then you have Rex, right? Titanic Hydra, Cinderhulk, and building a Randuin's here.
Randuin's? It could be a Randuin.
No, Frozen. I don't know. I think it's a Randuin's.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it is.
And he's gonna spit, and now they pick up another dragon for themselves. Yes, it's an Ocean Drake, so they get a little bit more regen in favor of this Vladimir. To get his health back a little bit, and Baron buff's about to run out, I believe, if hasn't already.
It's pretty close.
There you go.
A couple of seconds. There you go. It's just off now. But double Randuin's actually, coming out from AUB. One on Matty and one on Jett. That is horrible to look at as a Hecarim, isn't it? Just 2 AoE slows in a team fight, and then he's doing no bonus damage. It's just, it's not a fun game for him at all. But he has made some impressive plays. We'll have to give him that. ECL just trying their hardest now just to defend. Oh, sneaky. Jinx on that side. PLB.
So
DC. Okay. I thought he was being really clever by just standing still so Jett wouldn't spot him out, but he actually just DC'd by the looks of it.
Yep. And while we have this break, I want to make sure to mention ECL are still not out of this, right? They are falling a little bit behind the 7,000 gold, but we've seen games like this, even in LCS play, right? NA LCS. We have, you know, Cloud9 recently with the Apex game, right? They managed to play for about 69 minutes until they started winning. They were, got this with the Unchurch, killed this advantage, but they still managed to win, right? And this is what ECL are doing. They're turtling back, they're sitting at the back a little bit more, and they're trying to utilize it. I thought this was a sneaky play as well, unfortunately. The DC. DC.
We'll pretend she meant to do it.
It did no damage. Look at this. Rex is doing nothing. he has a chunk missing, which is not even mattered. Yeah, there we go. Look.
Well, we're back. Zedekus does get the knock-up as well. Andy there to try and stun him up. Nope. Zedekus says not today. Does get the flash away, but really. ECL, you're right. They're not out of this game, but AUB looking pretty strong at this point. And Jinx, I mean, like you just said, one rocket did, 50 damage maybe? So... Last Whisper into maybe more... Dominic's Regard. I think that shield want to pick up next.
Yep, but ZZ Rock pop behind sign just to try and rely a bit for like pressure from this lane. They'll be trying to stop the siege as much as they can, but can they? This is a full the full team of tanks and sieging champions, and if they pick you off, you're gone, right? Off the matter, deleted, RE.x, you know, RE.jpg deleted off the files. that's what's gonna be happening. They're a bit hesitant still.
Oh, MSR.
Okay. Hey, come on, you can't kill a tank like that, MSR. No.
Got excited. Come on.
Right. That's not his part. Jinx gets excited. Right. So
that's
maybe
true.
Right, maybe yeah. He was feeling like, you know, he needs to show PLB a little bit of his his inner Jinx. But I'm surprised. I still haven't seen a mastery hit from MSR. So he has stepped his BM. He's slowed, like, you know, he's being more professional, I guess. He's not playing BM, as well as he knows that he can be muted anyway, so his efforts would be in vain.
Yeah, that's very true. That's all of AUP just circling around this top side, while Matty in the bottom side just again continually pushing his bottom tower. So it does look like Bloody is going to have to defend it, but MSR in this lane pops Ghostblade to try and chase this iron down. He's doing a lot of damage as well. Phantom Dancer's completed, plus the extra BF sword. I can imagine, well, the looks of it, he's just going into a Merc Scimitar, possibly. I'm not entirely sure. He could go literally anything with that BF sword.
I think he's gonna go for the Merc, just to protect himself against the Cyan, you know, RE Charm. There's plenty of CC that can catch him out and really sway the fight. So he's taking the safer option there. He could have gone for something like Bloodthirster, which we haven't seen picked up on Lucian for a long while. It was most likely gonna be Jinx's next item there.
Yep, but does need the armor pen, I feel. Just because Matty, like, if you look at their items, just, yeah, you're doing no damage to those guys at all. Bonobo, though. Uh-oh, MSR's caught out. Oh, that's a lot of damage. MSR does get the dash away there, but Bonobo doing a lot. Here comes the sign. Use doesn't connect. Jinx Rocket flies by. Andy there as well, just to provide a little bit of protection. They look like they're going to turn this one around, but no. Lantern is going to be the savior, but MSR does get Stan United used upon him. Flash from Matty Triceps. Taunt not going to land on anybody. Actually, Woodley gets hooked straight into the tower, but pulls away. Absolutely. Whoa, that heal from Hemoplague as well. Jeez.
So we're back to point blank. Nothing happening. Ultimates wasted. Teleports and stuff wasted, but nothing picked up. Baron spawning in 3 seconds, and I'm not sure they're setting the trap up here, but I'm not sure they should go for it anyway.
If they want it, nope.
They do.
Like, they're going to say, you can take the Baron instead.
This is a dangerous call because all 5 members are alive and all 5 members are in the area. They still have Spirit Rush, they still have Onslaught of Shadows.
Do indeed.
And no one sees the second. Okay, now they do.
Now they do. There we go. Matty Tricep dives over the wall, gets the taunt on Bonobo, but Bonobo is going to get the lantern to safety. Woodleague on the side. No Hemoplague available from him. Oh, gets hooked. Wow, max range hook from them. Huge. This might be a kill. Yeah, Baron Buffer is taken, though, on the side of AUB. There goes the sign on. Straight into Matty Triceps. He is going to get knocked up. They're going to dive straight on top of him, soloing him out. Zoning him out, even. He is just so tanky, but he's going to go down eventually. Meanwhile, Andy actually picks up a kill, picking up Bonobo. By the looks of it, he just overextended a little too much.
Yep, and 2-4-1 and Baron pickup is something they'll be more than happy with, right? 13 kills to 10, still maintaining about 8,000 gold advantage. Bot lane was pushing in as well, so good macro play from there. And yes, ZZRO in the top lane is stopping them, but unfortunately that's not enough. And they have three members of Baron buff again, and they'll just go in there and just do the same siege they've been doing over. Hopefully this time they manage to pick up a kill and finish the game, because one kill at this moment in 35 minutes could make the difference, right? Elder Dragon is going to be the next dragon spawning on the Rift. So if they do manage to pick up, the burn will be honest as well. Yes, they don't have the Mountain Drake, but the true damage coming out of this is Elder Drake is good enough for them to you know, pretty much.
It's good enough for them to contest it. Surely. I mean, it's 2 minutes on the Elder Dragon buff, and realistically, Air Drake and, well, Cloud Drake even, sorry, and the Ocean Drake, not really something you want to buff up over the earth and fire, but hey, not gonna happen. MSR,
oh my God,
ooh, Bloody was a sick. Okay. He did have Flash and Spirit Rush available, so he doesn't actually use those, decides not to.
I think he thought he managed to escape and save those for a future fight, but
might not be
kill,
a future fight.
Yeah, this single kill caused them to lose an inhibitor, and I don't think they're gonna go for the game. My client broke.
No, everybody's paused for me as well. Is it just me? Pretty sure what's happening.
Nope, I'm frozen. So
yep. Okay. Okay, so we're frozen. The game is just kind of freezed up a little bit, but it does give us a little time to kind of analyse the map and where it's at the moment. I mean, Matty Triceps is in this top side, Stan United available, and Unbreak has got his TP and ultimate available as well, so Matty Triceps probably not joining this mid-squad of AUB anytime soon.
Unfortunately, I believe this is the bug that happens when the game ends, so...
Oh.
Yep, so we will not see any more of this action. This was probably the last push with the Baron and Shen in the backline stopping the Cyan, but I just quit the game, and unfortunately I have the screen in front of me, so there is no reconnection. There you go, spectator data invalid, the game will not exit. What we'll have to show you is the blue team win. Let's me quickly have a look at the difference. So they managed to pick up another fight. Yeah, they take 4 kills for no deaths.
Wow.
Yeah, 4 kills for no deaths just at the Nexus fight, because I'm just comparing stats on the side of Aston here. I do apologize. And that's game to Aston, right? Aston's winning this game. It wasn't the cleanest of games from both the teams. The French had a good early start, but they fell behind. Aston, they could have done way more, but the team comp from the French side didn't allow them to do much. They played safe, and unfortunately in this game, you know, it wasn't the flashiest, like the Italian game versus Portugal again, or this game, morning's game, Spain versus missing a team, Italy. So they're both Italy games. There you go.
Yeah, not the cleanest, but AUB taking the victory over ECL, which, you know, they've been doing, the UK squad have definitely been doing pretty well. 2 wins under their belt already. And, well, what can you really say? Who was your real MVP? Because MSR just did so much work in that game.
Yeah,
10-2-6.
It would definitely go to MSR in my bikes. 10-2-6, plenty of damage done, really good positioning. Even the last pick on Ari, man, it was insane. Good pickup, caused them inhale butter, and in the end, it won them the fight right at the end to win them the game. So that definitely goes to MSR. But I do have to say, Bonobo played really well in this game.
Oh, yeah.
On the side of the French, he caused so much havoc early in the game, proved himself that even if you target ban him, he'll pick something out of the bag and still carry the game. So really good play from the French side as well. They managed to keep hold of the game, even though they were behind later on. And even though it wasn't the flashiest of this game, it was still a good game. I really enjoyed it as well. I hope the guys that were watching enjoyed it, except for the final bug.
Yeah. Oh, spectator bugs do happen, but this has been the third day of the University Esports Masters. Obviously, my name has been Jack Jaws Wright, and that has been Zverin Last Saber, Istat. And we are going to have to leave it for today, but make sure you tune in tomorrow when the first game up will be Italy versus the French team you just saw. And we'll see if the French team can get a little bit of redemption tomorrow. But we're going to leave it at that, I think.
I think one more thing.
Oh,
we'll just run through the table quickly because
yes.
I like to
do
this.
Oh, yes, run through the table.
So now Italy with 2 games under the belt. They won both, so they'll be at the top of the table with 2 points. Followed by that, it will be Aston University with 2 wins and 1 loss. And so that's another 2 points. Followed by that, Portugal, who hasn't played yet, with 1 win, 1 loss. And then right under that is University of Madrid. 1 win, 2 losses. And France, unfortunately, closing the table up with 2 losses and 0 points.
Indeed, and we're just going to leave you with a little bit of music as we do head out. But thank you so much for watching, guys, and we'll see you, well, late tomorrow. I was going to say early tomorrow morning, but not at all. We'll see you guys tomorrow, and I hope you've all enjoyed it.
Take care, guys. Let's run away, run away. Let's run away, run away. Let's run away, run away. Let's go into the to the rock and
get lost.